congregation and remain standing for the national anthem. Our invocation today is by Brother Wayne Godsey.
Let us pray. Dear God, as we bow before you in your presence today, we are so grateful for the beautiful day that you've given us, for this very special event that you put these young people are going to enjoy. We thank you, Father, for both teams and their abilities. We pray, God, for your safety. We ask you, Lord, that you will be with the coaches as they make the decisions. We thank you for them and the decision-making time that they put into playing this game with these young people. The families that are represented in the home, God, we know are precious in your sight. And we thank you for loving us and caring for us. We just ask you, Lord, that you give safety to each player that's going to participate. Lord, may the best team win. In Jesus' name we pray.
Tom Davis Field tonight. This afternoon, the Overton County Outlaws will host the Carthage Jets in the 8 and 9 year old division. Both teams coming into today's ball game undefeated. Overton County will be on defense to start the contest. They'll be in the black jerseys with the white numerals. Carthage will be in the gold jerseys with the black numerals. Carthage coached by Randy Skurlock. He is assisted by John Foster, Stan Ellis, and David McDonald. Overton County, coached by Mark Hauser. He is assisted by Rick Coleman, Jerry McDonald, Dickie Mitchell, Alan Linder, Tim Smith, Jerry Cravens, Bobby Boswell, and Scott Trevathan. Carthage with the football to start the contest. The handoff will go to the tailback as he bounces it outside. Number 15, Corey McDonald, with a big run all the way inside Overton County territory down to the 45-yard line where they finally push him out of bounds. But McDonald with a big run for Carthage to get them started out good on their first possession. 25-yard run for Corey McDonald on the first play from scrimmage for the Carthage Jets. Hog-Eye in the backfield behind the quarterback, Hessen. Jimmy Hessen, number 11, is the quarterback for the Carthage Jets. The tailback is number 15, Corey McDonald. The handoff will go to McDonald again as he cuts it back inside, and McDonald's still on his feet. He'll have a first down. McDonald finally run down inside the 35-yard line, down at about the 32. Another good run for Corey McDonald, and an Outlaw shaken up on the play. Haven't been able to see a number as of yet for the player shaken up for Overton County, but Corey McDonald for two plays has taken the ball for successive first downs for Carthage. The injured player is number 77, David Stockton, as he is up now and will come out of the ball game. And Carthage now back up to the line of scrimmage. They're still in their power eye as they start play now. The pitch will go back to McDonald. Running around the left side, he uses the stiff arm. McDonald across the 30. He's down to the 28-yard line, where a good tackle is made by Overton County's number 82 on this side to make the stop is Chris Hammock for the Overton County Outlaws. But McDonald will pick up 5 on the play, setting up 2nd down and 5. Both teams come into today's ball game undefeated, so this for the lead in the Tri-Lakes Conference, as both compete in that conference in junior junior football. Fullbacks are number 20, Brandon Eden, and number 35, as Hessen takes the snap. He will give to Eden on the first back through. The other fullback is number 69 back there, John Thompson. Eden will pick up maybe a yard on the play. That will set up 3rd down and 5 now for the Carthage Owls. Or the Carthage Jets. First time they have faced a 3rd down in this ball game. 8 minutes to play in the first quarter. No score in the contest. Back now in there is number 39, Scott Oliver. Fumble on the play. Hessen picks it up. He'll take it forward across the 25, and Hessen will be very close to a 1st down on the carry, and he'll have it. So Hessen alertly picking up the bobbled snap and taking it forward for about 6 yards and a 1st down. They'll have it 1st and 10 at the Overton County 21-yard line where it's spotted down. Carthage taking the opening possession and have kept it now for over 2.5 minutes in this opening quarter. They have it 1st and 10 at the 21. Hessen will give to Eden running left. Eden will just wedge the ball forward for about 4 on the carry. There to make the stop, number 42, Andy Gray, and number 55, Derek Knappenberger. There for the stop. They'll give him 4 on the carry, so it now sets up 2nd down and 6. Inside the 20 there at about the 17-yard line of Overton County. Carthage taking a lot of time in the offensive huddle this time on 2nd and 7. Hessen will pitch back to McDonald. McDonald tries to turn the corner. Allen will try to string him out. McDonald gets away from him. McDonald turns the corner and takes it inside the 10-yard line, where he will, they'll say he stepped out of bounds at just about the 10, but he will have a 1st down just outside the 10-yard line, so Carthage can get a 1st down without getting a touchdown, as they're about a foot outside the 10-yard line. So McDonald has picked up 3 first downs now on this drive for his team. And they have it 1st and 10 from just inside the 11. Foster and Eden are the fullbacks. McDonald is the tailback behind Hessen. Hessen will pitch back to McDonald. He's looking to pass. He'll now pull it down. McDonald trying to bounce it outside. He breaks 2 tackles. still on his feet inside the 10 down to the 8-yard line, where he's finally pushed out of bounds by Overton County's number 38. Jonathan Stevens over there to push him out. They'll give him about 2 on the play, so it will set up 2nd down and 8 for Carthage now. Well, they now even spot him further down at the 7-yard line, so it's 2nd and 7 for Carthage as they were slow setting the yard markers on the far side of the field. Carthage with a 4-minute drive going right here. They have it 2nd and 7 at the Overton County 8-yard line. I formation, wing back to the right side this time. First time they have shown this formation. Hessen will keep it on the quarterback draw, and he'll take the football forward for a couple of yards down to about the 5-yard line. Number 92, Chris Bell, making the stop. It will set up 3rd and 5 now for Carthage. First time they have faced 3rd down. Or rather, the 2nd time they have faced 3rd down this drive, able to convert on the last one. As the quarterback Hessen bobbled the snap and picked it up, took the ball forward for the necessary yardage to pick up the 1st down. So it's now 3rd down and 5 from just about the 6-yard line. High formation this time behind Hessen. Hessen will pitch back to McDonald. McDonald cuts inside his block. McDonald caught at about the 2-yard line. I believe he'll be short of the 1st down. We'll have to wait and check the spot. Number 26, Bill Garrett over there to make the stop. He will be short of the 1st down, about 2 yards short. So now it's 4th down and 2 for Carthage, and they'll take a timeout. 4th and 2 for Carthage. They're at the 3-yard line. They can get a 1st down without picking up the touchdown. Can the Carthage Owls? Hessen will hand off to McDonald running left, and he has stopped short of the touchdown. Jeremy McDonald there to wrap him up for the Outlaws. So the defense holds. Carthage kept that football almost 5.5 minutes and came up with nothing. And Overton County will take over at the 2-yard line, where they'll have it 1st and 10. The Overton County offense will come out. Now they're going to measure, as it appeared he was stopped well short of that 1st down, but apparently it is close enough for a measurement. It appeared he was about a yard shy of that 1st down. And he is short of the 1st down. So the defense does hold, and Overton County's offense will come onto the field now. They are led by number 9, Chris Everly. He is the quarterback. The tailback is number 10, Jaran Allen. Allen averages 3 touchdowns a ball game. In his last one, he had 4. The fullback is Brandon Smith. They run a 2 tight end set. The left tight end is Josh Godsey. He wears number 15. The right tight end is number 82, Chris Hammock. The offensive line, the center is number 55, Derek Knappenberger. The left guard is number 58, Matt Copeland, and we'll set the rest after this play. Everly takes the snap. He hands off to Allen. Allen up the middle of the field for about 4 yards on the play. Make it a 3-yard carry for Duran. He has 925 yards on the season. So now needing only 72 to break the 1,000-yard rushing barrier. The left tackle for Overton County is number 70, Clint Melton. The right tackle is number 77, David Stockton. And the right guard is number 90, Jeremy McDonald. It's now on 2nd and 7, Overton County back out of the offensive huddle. Just just trying to keep the football in the center of the field and wedge it out. Allen tries to bounce it outside. He breaks one tackle. Allen across the 10. He's across the 20. Allen has open field. Allen across the 40. He's across midfield. And Copeland will catch him at the 38-yard line. A 57-yard run for Duran Allen. Unofficially, we have him with a 57-yard run, taking it from the 5-yard line down to the 37, where Allen will set Overton County up with 1st and 10 inside Carthage territory. And Copeland, Corey McDonald, number 15, Corey McDonald, able to run him down. McDonald showed great speed in catching Allen from behind. Allen now tries the left side. And again, I believe it's McDonald over there to make the stop. And it is Corey McDonald. So he is keying on Duran Allen. And he will stop him for no gain. So Allen now with 3 carries, he has 60 yards on the day. And Overton County will be faced with a 2nd and 11 now, with only 2.5 minutes to play in the first quarter. Power eye this time for the Outlaws. Motion on the right side of the Outlaw offensive line, so they'll take a 5-yard penalty against Overton County. Instead of having 2nd and 11, they'll now have it 2nd and 16 from back at the 44-yard line of Carthage. The illegal procedure call against the right side of the offensive line. So now they'll have it 2nd and 16. Will Overton County. Again in the power eye. They'll hand off to Allen. Allen slips down, and he'll lose a couple on the play. Back outside the 45 to the 46-yard line. So now it's 3rd down and about 18 for Overton County. Possibly they may have to look to the pass here on 3rd and long. This field position, they'll take 2 downs to try to pick up the 1st, probably. If they can get at least half of it on this down, they probably will. Everly will keep. He's using Allen as an extra blocker out there. Everly across the 45, cuts inside, and Everly is down to the 40-yard line. A 6-yard run for Chris Everly for Overton County. And he will set up 4th down and 12 now for the Outlaws, and they are going to go for it, it appears, and they'll take a timeout. 4th and 12 for the Overton County Outlaws. The handoff will go to Allen up the center of the field, just trying to wedge it out and get good field position. Allen will pick up 6 as he takes the football down to the 35-yard line. So now Carthage will take over on downs, 1st and 10. With 54 seconds to play in the first quarter, still no score in the ball game. Both teams able to take the football inside the other's territory and then stop on downs. Carthage quickly out of the offensive huddle this time. Power eye behind Hessen. Motion on both the offensive and defensive lines. We'll have to see what the call is. It appeared Carthage may have started just a little early on the right side of that defensive line. And it is stepped off against them, so a 5-yard penalty against the Carthage Jets moves them back to the 30-yard line, where instead of having it 1st and 10, they'll have the football 1st and 15 back at the 30-yard line. So that taking away a little bit of their excellent field position. Clock moving with 25 seconds. This will probably be the final play of the quarter. Hessen back to pass. He's going deep. It's incomplete to number 31, Ryan White. The pass intended for White, and it was in his hands. White unable to pull it in. So it will set up second and 15 now for Carthage with 12 seconds to play in the first quarter. So they will be able to run another play. Carthage is Hessen, the only player to attempt a pass in this ball game. He is 0 for 1 on the night. They line up in an I formation. They'll give on the reverse to White. Excuse me, that's number 69, I believe, carrying the football. He's still on his feet. Number 39, Scott Oliver, with the carry. Very close to the first down as he is at the 44-yard line, so he'll be stopped about 2 yards short. They spy him at the 43, so it will be third down and 2 when we come back for the second quarter. Third down and 2 for the Carthage Jets. I formation behind them. Handoff will go to the fullback, Eden, on the carry, and I believe he'll have the first down as they give him a good spot. Eden forced back with a good hit by the Overton County defense, but the officials coming in gave him an excellent spot on that play for Carthage. And Eden will pick up a couple of yards up to the 46-yard line and a first down. Chris Hammock there on the stop for Overton County. They're at about the 46-yard line. First and 10, Carthage. Second play of the second quarter. Play fake. Hessen trying the pass. It's incomplete to Ryan White. That'll bring up second and 10. Now Hessen 0 for 2 on the afternoon. And Carthage trying to show that they can pass the ball this afternoon. They have had a couple of players open. Hessen got the ball there the first time, and they couldn't pull it in. That time he missed his wide receiver. So both passes falling incomplete, and it will set up second and 10 for Carthage now. Handoff will go to McDonald. Fumble on the play, and Overton County's number 90 fell on it. Jeremy McDonald, I believe, is the player with the football. And Overton County will get the turnover as Corey McDonald couldn't hang on to the football and turns it over to the Overton County Outlaws, and they get the first big play of this contest. And they'll have it first and 10 at the Carthage 42-yard line. Allen needs only 11 yards to break the 1,000-yard mark for Overton County, as he had 64 in the first quarter. High formation behind Everly. Everly back to pass. He has pressure. Everly steps away from it, and he'll be sacked. Number 73 back there, Brian Shoulders, with the sack. And it's a 9-yard loss. For Everly, as Shoulders was able to get in there. And it will set up second down and 19. For Overton County. Everly will hand off to Allen. Allen will bounce it outside, and Allen will pick up about 3 on the carry. And it will set up third down and 16. Make it third and 17. As they have a long way to go for the first down. 7 minutes, 40 seconds to play in the first half. No score in the contest. Flag down on the play as the pass by Everly is incomplete. It was intended for number 15, Josh Godsey. But there is a flag down on the play, and I believe it will probably be motion or offsides as it was a dead ball foul, it appears. It was against Carthage, so it would have been offsides against them, a 5-yard penalty. That will set up 3rd and 13 now for the Outlaws. Wide receiver to the right side. The handoff will go to Allen. Allen caught for a yard loss on the play. And Carthage is really keen on Jerran Allen as they are all looking for him on every play. As he will lose a couple, and that will set up 4th and 14. So the Outlaws are going to punt to Carthage. And in the 8- and 9-year-old division, they just walk it down the field 30 yards. And that is where the other team gets possession. So Overton County trying to get the field possession in their favor. Ball is spotted down at the 16-yard line, where it will be 1st and 10, Carthage. 6 minutes, 56 seconds to play in the first half. Carthage breaks the offensive huddle. McDonald is the tailback. He goes in motion, says McDonald. Hessen keeps it up the center of the field for a couple of yards. Jeremy McDonald in there to make the stop once again. Give him one on the play. That will set up 2nd and 9. For Carthage. So both teams keeping the football on the ground. Overton County has not attempted a pass. Carthage 0-for-2 on the afternoon. Carthage back up to the line of scrimmage on 2nd and 9. I formation behind Hessen. Wing back to the right side. Hessen will pitch back to McDonald. McDonald will cut it back across the 25. McDonald across the 30. McDonald gives ground. He's back across the 30 to the 32-yard line, where he's finally hemmed in by a whole group of Overton County defenders. Number 55 is the player getting up off the bottom of the pile, Derek Knappenberger. And number 77, David Stockton, there as well for Overton County, along with 56, Andy Worley. But it will be a first down as you look at the run by the Carthage running back, McDonald, again, as he takes it up across the 30-yard line. A couple of good moves shown by McDonald there before he's taken down by 4 or 5 of the Outlaw defenders. It's a first down for Carthage, though, at the 32-yard line. Carthage taking a lot of time in the offensive huddle. The clock moving down to about 5 minutes to play in the ball game. A lot of pressure on these outside corners for Overton County. Allen plays on the left side of the defense. Everly on the right. Another fumble on the play. And Carthage will come up with it. The quarterback, Hessen. No, the center, I believe, able to follow it. No, that's the fullback, Eden, coming out of the bottom of the pile. Brandon Eden with the recovery. He'll be down at the line of scrimmage, so it will be 2nd down and 10. Now for Carthage. Power Eye this time. Hessen will give to the first man through, and he won't gain anything. Scott Oliver on the carry. Number 77, David Stockton there for the stop. And Oliver got back to the line of scrimmage. That will set up third down and 10 for Carthage with 4 minutes to play in the ball game. Carthage back up the line of scrimmage. No score in the ball game. Oliver is a wing back to the left side. Pitch will go back to McDonald. McDonald trying to turn it outside. He uses the stiff arm. McDonald will try to bounce it back this way. McDonald still on his feet. McDonald up to the 37-yard line where he's brought down by number 82, Chris Hammock, there on the defensive stop. And McDonald probably ran about 60 yards to get that five. So it will set up third down and 4. For Carthage, make it 4th and 4 from the 38-yard line. And Hammock with a good tackle, as it appeared McDonald might have had open field. Hammock closing well, showing he had some pretty good speed to run down McDonald. And on 4th and 4, Carthage taking a lot of time again. Clock running, 2 minutes 45 seconds to play in the first half. Carthage still in the huddle. They now come out. Hessen takes the snap. Hessen looking to pass. The pass down the middle of the field is intercepted. Number 38, Jonathan Stevens with the interception. And 2 weeks in a row, Stevens has got an interception for the Outlaws. That one stopping the Carthage drive. Overton County will have the football at the 49. So Stevens with the big interception for Overton County gives his offense the football at midfield with 2 minutes 18 seconds to play in the first half. Power Eye for the Outlaws. The give will go to the fullback, number 82, Hammock on the carry. And he'll take it forward for about 9. So they're mixing it up for Overton County as they give the handoff to Hammock. As Carthage is just keying on Jerran Allen, and Overton County trying to give the football to other people to get them into the offense. 2nd down and 2 facing Carthage. 1.5 minutes to play. Overton County in the Power Eye. Handoff will go to the fullback as the ball is loose, I believe. And Carthage has recovered. Number 11, Jim Hessen, coming out of the bottom of the pile with the football. So the teams exchange turnovers. And now Carthage will have it 1st and 10 at the 43-yard line. 1:27 to play in the first half. No score in the ball game. Carthage with 2 timeouts remaining. Pitchback will go to McDonald. McDonald's going to throw over the middle of the field. It's complete to White. White inside Overton County territory down to the 35-yard line. So Carthage on the halfback pass play picks up big yardage for the first down. An 18-yard gain, they say. So it will set up 1st and 10 for Carthage there at the 36-yard line. And Carthage takes a timeout. Carthage has the football, 1st and 10 at the 36-yard line. Tailback is McDonald. Fake to McDonald. Hessen coming on the naked bootleg, and he'll be caught by Jerran Allen back for a big loss, an 8-yard loss for Jim Hessen back to the 44-yard line. So it will set up 2nd and 18 now for Carthage as the Outlaw defense throwing Carthage for a big loss and the offense ready to play. The defense back up to the line of scrimmage. Hessen will hand off to the fullback, but a flag comes down, and I'm not sure if Carthage was set for a complete second on that play. I believe they tried to get that snap off so quickly to try to catch this defense asleep that they weren't set the second that they have to be. So it's a 5-yard penalty against the Carthage Owls, or the Carthage Jets. They now face 2nd down and 23 after the penalty with 28 seconds to play in the first half. Power eye behind Hessen. Play fake. Hessen going deep for White, and it's incomplete. So now they'll bring up 3rd down and 23 with 20 seconds to play. And again, that pass coming in a little bit low to White, down around his knees. White unable to pull it in. It would have been a difficult catch for him to make. And again, Carthage quickly to the line of scrimmage. McDonald cuts it around the right side where Allen wraps him up. Jerran Allen catches Corey McDonald for a 2-yard loss. And Carthage takes the timeout. 4th and 24 facing the Carthage Owls after the good defensive play by Jerran Allen on the right side of the offensive unit. Give will go to the fullback, Eden. And Eden will be stopped short of the first down. Derek Knappenberger and Jeremy McDonald there to make the stop, and Overton County will take over inside Carthage territory with 7 seconds to play, and they'll take a timeout. 1st and 10 for the Outlaws. They put Allen in motion. Everly back to pass. He's looking towards Allen. He's got pressure. He'll come back to the short side to Stevens, and it's incomplete, and that will be the final play of the first half. At the end of 2, we're tied at 0. Back for the second half, the Overton County Outlaws tied with the Carthage Jets at 0-0. Overton County will have the football to start the second half. They are being led in rushing in this ballgame by Jerran Allen. He has 65 yards. Jerran only needs 10 yards in this second half to go over the 1,000-yard mark for the season. Coming in with 925, Everly will hand off to the first back, Drew Hammock, and he fumbles the football, and Carthage recovers at the 31. So Carthage comes out with the big play to start the second half. It will be recovered at the 32-yard line, where Carthage will have it 1st down and 10, and they've got a short field to work with here early in this second half. Clock moving, 9 minutes, 30 seconds to play in the third quarter. No score in the ball game. Power eye behind Hessen. Pitch back will go to McDonald deep. He's going to throw. McDonald going deep for White. It's caught. White at the 15. Cuts back at the 10. White down to the 5. Touchdown, Ryan White.
Jeff on the
opposite pass, tailback
Corey McDonald,
15. Corey McDonald to Ryan White for the 32-yard touchdown.
For the Carthage touchdown.
On the halfback option pass, and Carthage takes the lead 6-0. Now they'll go for the conversion. If they run this conversion in, if they're able to, they'll get 1 point. If they pass the conversion in, it will be for two. So Carthage lining up at the power eye. Hessen takes the snap. He's looking to throw into the end zone. It's complete to White again. And Ryan White catches the two-point conversion.
Pass on. Give Hessen to Ryan White. For the two-point conversion.
To 8-0. Carthage on top. 9:13 to play in the third quarter. So immediately after the Overton County turnover, the Carthage offense able to capitalize on the big 32-yard touchdown pass from Corey McDonald to Ryan White. McDonald throwing the football left-handed that time, a left-handed option pass from Corey McDonald. Three down linemen for the Carthage Owls. Everly will hand off to the fullback, number 26, Bill Garrett on the carry. And Garrett will take the football forward for a good gain. About 7 on the play. Make it 8, setting up 2nd down and 2. Now for Overton County. Power eye again for Overton County as they're running exclusively out of this in this set. Hand off to the fullback again, and he'll be stopped short of the line of scrimmage, I believe. Garrett again on the carry. It will be 3rd down and 2 now. As they spot him for a yard loss on the play. So it's 3rd and 3 for the Overton County Outlaws. First 3rd down they have faced in this second half. Everly will hand off to Allen, and Allen is thrown for a loss in the backfield. Good defensive penetration by the Carthage Owls. Number 61, Michael Hicks there, along with number 86, Jonathan Sloan. And it was a 4-yard loss for Allen. And Overton County will punt the football to Carthage, so they'll walk the football 30 yards down the field. Carthage will take over at their own 37-yard line.
First down.
Well, they'll have it 1st and 10.
Carthage, 37. First down, 10.
Carthage defense doing a good job here in this ball game, shutting the Outlaws out in this third quarter as we've got 7:20 to play in the third. Carthage with their second possession of this third quarter. Overton County running 4 offensive plays thus far in the quarter. Handoff will go to Eaton. Eaton off the left side. He has good yardage, close to a 1st down. As Eaton takes it for about 9, and there appears to be an Outlaw shaken up on the play. Chris Hammock there for Overton County, along with Andy Worley to make the stop. And he will have a 1st down as they give him 10 on the carry out to the 46. So it will be 1st and 10. Carthage. Their offense beginning to work now. The passes that they have attempted beginning to open up some of the running lanes for the Carthage running back. Hessen will pitch back to McDonald. McDonald will try to bounce it outside. McDonald across the 45, he's across midfield. McDonald to the 45, makes a move to the 40, and he's down to the 38-yard line, where he finally ran down on the far sideline by Overton County Stevens, along with number 55, Derek Mappenberger. But there is a penalty marker down on the play. And apparently they're going to move Carthage back, as he is talking to the Overton County captain. And it will be a step-off against the Carthage Owls. No signal from the referee as to what the penalty was. A 10-yard penalty, so probably offensive holding. And that is the call as they move it back, to the 36-yard line. where it will be first and 20.
Ball up 10 yards.
Now for the Carthage
Jets. First down 20, Carthage.
Clock moving with 6 minutes 20 seconds to play in the third quarter. Carthage on top, 8-0. Ball is at the 36-yard line. Carthage breaks the offensive huddle. They line up in a straight eye this time as they put a wing back off to the left side. That's Oliver. The handoff will go to Oliver on the misdirection. And Oliver is caught by Allen. Oliver struggles back to the line of scrimmage, but a good job by Duran Allen on the far side to make that tackle. As he wasn't fooled on the reverse. So it will be second down and 10, or rather second down and 20, after the holding penalty called on the original first down play for Carthage. Now with second and 20 facing the Carthage Owls, they may have to try that passing game again. Movement on the line of scrimmage. Hessen starts to play. The Overton County defensive line jump did not appear as if they made contact. And they did not. The offensive line moving, drawing them across. So a 5-yard penalty against Carthage. And now they face second down at about 26. They have to go from their 30 to the Overton County 44 for the first down. Carthage with a lot of yardage between them and the first down marker. They break the offensive huddle. Eye formation. Hessen with the play fake. Hessen going to wide, and it's underthrown. Stevens made a good break on that football, had the opportunity for the interception, but it's well underthrown. So he was unable to get there. And it will now bring up third down and 26 for Carthage. Third 26 facing the Carthage Jets. .446 to play in the third quarter. Clock stopped after the incomplete pass. Carthage taking a lot of time again, as it takes them about 30 to 45 seconds each time they go into that offensive huddle. Now break out of it on third and 26. McDonald is the tailback. Hessen running behind McDonald and Eaton, and Hessen is caught in the backfield. Number 70, Clint Melton over there for the stop.
Jim Hessen on the quarterback roll. Runs into the left side of the
That was number 20 on the stop, Brandon Smith. Also over there, so that will bring up a punting situation for Carthage. As Smith making the good stop.
County will have the football at the
41, where they'll have it first and 10, so the teams exchange punts. First and 10 from the 40. 8-0. Carthage on top. 4:20 to play in the third quarter. Everly gives to the fullback. Fumble on the play. And Carthage has recovered. So this is for the second time in this third quarter. The Carthage Jets recover an Overton County fumble. Deep inside outlaw territory. They'll take it over at the 37-yard line.
Side over County territory at 37. First down. 10 yards to go. Carthage
now, if they could score here, the way they're playing defense, that could just about put this ball game away. First and 10 for them from the 37-yard line. High formation behind Hessen. Pitch will go back to McDonald. He's going to pass again. McDonald now will pull it down and run. McDonald breaks the tackle at the 40. He steps out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Where it will be a four-yard gain for Corey McDonald. And it will set up second down and six. Make it a three-yard gain for McDonald, so it will set up second down and seven for Carthage. Worley there to knock him out of bounds. .43 to play in the third quarter now as Carthage comes up to the line of scrimmage. Power eye again. Two tight ends set. Hessen will hand off to Eaton. Eaton running up the center of the field. He'll have good yardage and Eaton will be close to a first down as he takes the football down inside the 30 to the 28. And it may be close enough for a measure. That'll be third down. And less than a yard for the
third down, a long yard.
So they're at the 28-yard line. And they need to go about a yard for the first down, does Carthage. Number 58 checking in the Overton County lineup. That's Matt Copeland coming in. Carthage on third and one. Man in motion is Oliver. A handoff will go to McDonald. McDonald has the first down as he takes it down inside the 25 for the Carthage first down. Bill Garrett and David Stockton there to make the stop for the Overton County Outlaws, but it will be another first down. Carthage. That's why he's taking the clock down inside 240 to play. It's just now 237. Carthage on first and 10 from the 25. Hessen will pitch back to McDonald. McDonald looking to pass again. He's going in deep, and it's overthrown over the head of White. As Stevens had the coverage down there. On the halfback option, this one falling incomplete. And it will set up second down and 10 for Carthage. They're at the 25-yard line of Overton County. Power eye again. The pitch will go back to McDonald. McDonald looking to pass again. He has pressure. McDonald will run away from it. McDonald's still on his feet, and he'll pick up a yard as it appeared as if the Overton County Outlaws had him hemmed in back in the pocket. But he was just able to bounce it outside and take the football forward for positive yardage down to the 23-yard line, where it will be third down and a short nine for the first down. Clock stopped with a minute 55 to play in the third quarter as Hammock, the Overton County player, to push him out of bounds. Third down and nine for the Carthage Owls. They lead 8-0. Handoff will go to Eaton. Eaton trying to turn it up on the right side. We'll get maybe a yard on the play. There's a flag down. Jeremy McDonald there on the stop. Along with Duran Allen.
Number 90, Jeremy McDonald. Flag on the play.
It appears as if it will be a face mask call against Overton County. They'll step off 5 yards from the spot of the foul. So the Carthage Jets will still be short of the first down by about 4 yards. Now fourth down and four for the Carthage Owls. They're inside the 20 at the 19-yard line. 55 seconds to play in the third quarter.
Go Outlaw fans, let's get behind the defense here. Let's go ahead.
High formation, they move the wing back to the left side. Hessen looking to pass. Bill Garrett with the interception. Garrett up across the 20 to the 25-yard line. And Garrett with the big interception, the second of the day for the Outlaws, will give them the first down at the 25-yard line. Stevens with the interception in the first half, stopping the drive, and now Bill Garrett gets the turnover for the Overton County Outlaws, and they'll have it first and 10 with 28 seconds to play in the third quarter. Clock moving. This will probably be the final play of the quarter for Overton County. Everly is the quarterback. Pitch back to Allen. Allen is looking to pass. He's going to get the Stevens. It's complete. Stevens across the 50 to the 43-yard line for the first down. So Stevens with the 15-yard reception on the halfback option pass from Overton County. Picks up the first down. And that will be the final play of the quarter. After three, Carthage leads 8-0.
A first down, 10 yards to go.
Ball spotted down at the 42-yard line to start the fourth quarter. Outlaws trailing 8-0. Carthage scoring on a 31-yard touchdown halfback option pass in the third quarter as Everly has pressure in the backfield. Everly still on his feet. Everly looks for a block on the near sideline. He cuts it up behind his blocker, fumble on the play. And Carthage has recovered for the third time in this second half. Third fumble recovery of the game for the second half for the Carthage Jets, and they have a player shaken up on the play. Now he is up. Carthage again will have good field position to start this drive. They're at the 42-yard line of Overton County. Where it'll be first and 10. Number 42, Andy Gray checking in the Overton County lineup. Just underway in the fourth quarter. Both of these teams coming into this football game undefeated. This for the season title in the Tri-Lakes Conference. Hessen will hand off to McDonald. McDonald fumbles, the ball still loose. And Overton County gets it back. For the second time today, Corey McDonald puts the football on the turf. And I believe number 90, Jeremy McDonald, was the player that came up with it. Overton County will have the football first and 10 at their 44-yard line. Stevens sets up as a receiver to the right side. Everly hands off to Allen. To try to tie this ball game up as Carthage is able to convert on the two-point conversion. So Allen with 117.
Hey, get your horn down there.
So give him 1,042 unofficially on the season. for Durant Allen. And we'll check the number of touchdowns he has in just a moment. I know that puts him over 100 points scoring. They're going to throw the halfback off. Defensive play by Allen to throw them a lot for a loss. They'll give off in this direction to Oliver, and he stumbles to the ground. So they'll again lose three. Back to the 21, making a four-yard loss. That will set up third down and 19 for the Carthage Jets now. And this Overton County defense really playing ball now after the offense bringing them back to tie the score at 8-8. 7:38 to play. Ball game, tied at 8 apiece. They do play overtime in junior football, and I believe it works just as the high school overtime works. So if so, they will each, barring provided that they do not break this tie, they would have to the football at the 10-yard line. Each team get four cracks at the end zone. Power eye behind Hessen. Hessen will pitch back to McDonald. He's going to pass. He's going to wide. It's caught. Wide up across the 40. Carthage will keep the football. They'll have it first and 10 at the 44-yard line. White with the reception for the first down to keep the Carthage drive alive. And now they have it first and 10 from their 44. Handoff will go to the fullback. Fumble. Eden fumbles the football. But he's able to fall on it for a one-yard loss. So it will set up second and 11 for Carthage now. As Eden puts the ball on the ground again. As here you see the pass from White, and let's see if we can see if that was a fumble. White did appear as if the knee hit before the ball came loose. So that's a good call by the official. It appeared the right knee came down before the ball came loose. It's second down and 11 now for the Carthage Jets. 6 minutes to play in the ball game. Power eye behind Hessen. Oliver in motion. Hessen will keep. Hessen turns it upfield. Hessen has run, and then he is hit hard. Let's see who that is. That's Bill Garrett with the big hit. Garrett, after a one-yard 9-yard gain, Ben Heston, for a solid lead. And it will bring up third down for Carthage then. Third and 10 facing the Carthage Jets.
Third down, 10 yards to go again.
As they try to break this 8-8 tie. Ball is at the 45-yard line. Power aisle, third and 9. Heston looking to throw. He's going to White. It's caught. And it will depend on the spot. It's a first down. I believe it's a first down as they're spotting the ball. Well, I don't know now. It's very close. They're going to measure. Going to measure from the far sidelines as it appeared the outside official had put the football down and they threw it into the center of the field to the other man. And I don't understand why you would do that if you're going to measure. It is short of the first down by just inches, just a couple of inches short. So it will bring up fourth down and inches for the Carthage Jets. And a big defensive play for Overton County here. If they can hold, they will give their offense 4.5 minutes to work with. Of course, if Carthage can convert, they will have good field position and a first down. Carthage taking a world of time as they try to set this offensive play. They line up in an I formation. Oliver is a wing back to the right side. Heston just wedges it out and he'll have the first down. As Jim Heston keeps and goes off the back of his center and they spot it at the 45-yard line. So it's a first down for the Carthage Jets. And they'll have it first and 10 from the Overton County, 45. Carthage trying to mount a drive to break this tie as Overton County. On the 56-yard touchdown run by Duran Allen, then the two-point conversion pass from Allen to Stevens tied the score at 8-8. Carthage has had the football since that time. Heston looking to pass again. He's looking to White. White's open again. White with the reception down to the 34-yard line. And Ryan White will give Carthage another first down. And White has a touchdown today. He caught the 32-yard touchdown from Corey McDonald on the halfback option pass, which gave Carthage the lead in the third quarter. The ball is at the 34-yard line of Overton County. First and 10 for Carthage. Heston will pitch back to McDonald. McDonald tries the left side. Allen, he'll break the tackle of Allen, and then another Overton County defender comes up to wrap him up. That's Bill Jarrett again on the stop. As McDonald will lose three on the play. That will set up second and 13 for Carthage. 2 minutes, 50 seconds to play in the ball game. And Carthage will take a timeout. Second down and 12 for the Carthage Jets. They're at the Overton County 37-yard line. Score tied at 8-8. 2 minutes, 51 seconds to play in regulation. They come out again, that two tight end set. Heston looking to pass again. He swings it out to McDonald. McDonald is caught by Allen. McDonald will lose about 3 yards on the play. And now Allen is just shadowing McDonald on every play. And it's third down and 16
pull down by number 10.
For the Carthage Jets. 2:25 to play in regulation. Both teams have pretty much been stifled in this ballgame, but each getting one big play apiece to score. Even and wide are the fullbacks. Hessen looking to pass. He'll fling it out to McDonald. McDonald up across the 30. 35 down to the 31. About a 9-yard gain. That will set up fourth down and 8. It appears that Hessen is shaken up, the Carthage quarterback, as he was hit hard as he released that football. Hessen shaken up for Carthage, and with the injury, we'll take a timeout. Hessen able to leave the football field, but it appeared as if he was holding his left hamstring. So that may be the injury to Jim Hessen. We'll have to wait and see who Carthage puts in the quarterback. It could be number 15, Corey McDonald, who has thrown a touchdown pass on an option from his halfback position. And now Carthage up to the line of scrimmage on 4th and 8. 1:46 to play in the ballgame. McDonald is the quarterback. He's looking to pass. He has pressure from McDonald. McDonald rolls left. He has the first down. McDonald down to the 20. He's pushed out of bounds at the 16-yard line. But Corey McDonald will pick up the first down for Carthage.
15, Corey McDonald.
And he will stop the clock by going out of bounds. So they have 1:36 to play now in regulation. Looks as if there's a flag down on the play to be tacked on after the run.
Pick up on about 15.
It will be a 5-yard step off against Overton County after the play. No signal from the official as to what the penalty was. It was a face mask call against Overton County. Ball is spotted down just outside the 11-yard line, where it's 1st and 10. For Carthage, 1:36 to play in the ball game, and Overton County takes a timeout. 1st and 10, Carthage from the Overton County 12-yard line. Power eye. Behind McDonald. McDonald will pass. He's looking to the end zone. He's hit as he throws. It falls incomplete. The pass intended for Oliver. And it appears Jim Hessen is all right. He may come back into this ballgame. As he has ran at least 200 yards in the last little bit, warming up. Ran from one end of this football field to the other. So we may see him again on 2nd and 10 from the 12. Carthage back up to the line of scrimmage. Running backs are staggered a little bit behind McDonald this time. McDonald will keep it himself on the bootleg. McDonald makes a move on the outside, but he can't shut the tackle of number 38, Jonathan Stevens, over there for Overton County to make the stop. No gain on the play for Carthage, so it sets up 3rd down and 10. Clock is running now with 1:05 to play in the ball game. And Carthage will burn their 2nd timeout. 3rd down and 10 from the 12-yard line for Carthage in an 8-8 tie. McDonald has pressure. McDonald gets away from it in the backfield. McDonald tried to bounce it outside. He can't get out of bounds. Overton County hemmed him in for a two-yard loss. It will set up fourth and 12. Now Carthage letting the clock move. They may just let it run down and take one shot at the end zone. As the clock sitting now at 30 seconds to play in the ball game. Overton County gets number 55, Derek Knappenberger, into the lineup. Fourth of 12 for Carthage. They have to get just inside the two for the first down, 13 yards for the touchdown. And Carthage takes the timeout at 8 seconds to set this last play.
Timeout, Carthage.
Ball is spotted down at the 14-yard line. Carthage gets one play to try to break this tie. McDonald, back to pass. He has pressure. County will have to take a timeout quickly. And they do take their timeout there, so they're going to take one play to try to break this 8-8 tie.
Timeout, Overton County.
10, Overton County at the 23-yard line. And you have to think, with 2 seconds remaining on the clock, that Jerran Allen is somehow going to get his hands on this football. Allen is the tailback. They run a two tight end set. Everly running the option. Handed off to Hammock. Chris Hammock on the carry for Overton County, and he'll be stopped. That will be the final play of regulation. After four, we're tied at 8-8. Overton County and Carthage tied up at 8 apiece. In the overtime, they will play it just like high school. They will go four downs from the 10-yard line. They each get four downs to try to score. The other team then will have four downs to try to score, and then we keep going until we break the tie. Carthage will be on offense first. Overton County won the toss. They decided to defer and play defense first, so they would know what they would need, basically, to try to defeat Carthage should they score. Carthage's Jim Heston is back in the lineup after leaving late in the fourth quarter with a hamstring injury. The handoff will go to Oliver on the misdirection carry by the fullback. And he'll pick up a couple on the play. That will set up second and goal from the 8-yard line now.
Pick up two. Second down, goal from the 8.
These two teams, both undefeated in the Tri-Lakes Conference. This for the title. And the two teams undefeated tied 8-8 and going into overtime. This is about the most fitting game you could have for a conference championship. Man in motion is Oliver. Hessen will pitch back to McDonald. McDonald off the left side. He breaks one tackle. McDonald down to the 5-yard line before he's stacked up and stopped for a 3-yard pickup. That will bring up third down and goal now for Carthage.
Pick up a three. Third down.
Two downs to pick up the 5 yards they need to get in the end zone, does Carthage, to try to break this 8-8 tie. Taking a lot of time in the offensive huddle is Carthage. And apparently there is no delay of game call in junior football. Power eye this time behind Hessen. Oliver in motion again. The give will go to McDonald. McDonald cuts it upfield, and McDonald scores. Corey McDonald, 5 yards down. Gives Carthage a 6-point advantage, and now they will go for the conversion. And we will have to wait and see. If they pass it in again, they get two on the conversion. If they run it in, they get one on the conversion. So we'll have to wait and see what the Carthage Jets will try to do. they were able to convert earlier in the game on a two-point conversion. When McDonald hit Ryan White on a halfback option. Hessen will hand off to McDonald trying to run it in. There's a flag down as McDonald does not get in. But there is a penalty marker down. It's against Carthage. So the Outlaws will decline it. And they will be on offense with four downs to try to retie this score or take the lead in the first overtime. Overton County trailing 14-8. The Outlaws on offense for the first time in overtime. Carthage scoring on a 5-yard run by Corey McDonald. His first touchdown rushing of the night. He has thrown a touchdown pass. Overton County scoring on a 56-yard touchdown run from Durant Howell. And now the Outlaws up the line of scrimmage. Stevens comes wide right. Everly, fumble on the play. It appears that the ball came loose, but Everly still with it. Will lose yardage. He'll lose a couple. Making the line of scrimmage the 13-yard line, so a 3-yard loss. That will set up second and goal from the 13. As Everly losing a couple, as it appeared there was a mix-up in there on the offensive unit. Everly hands off to Allen. Allen trying to bounce it outside. Allen gets the corner, but Carthage is there to stack him up. Good defensive serve by number 58 for Carthage. Timmy Phillips making the stop. Allen will gain a couple, moving the ball back down to the 11. So that will set up third and goal now from the 11-yard line for the Outlaws. They have two down to try to retie this ball game. 14-8, Carthage on top. They broke the 8-8 tie in the first overtime on a 5-yard run by McDonald. Stevens comes wide right. Everly running the bootleg. Everly breaks the tackle in the backfield. Everly tries to bounce it outside, but McDonald is there to bring him down. Corey McDonald making a good defensive stop out there as he had Everly one-on-one. And McDonald able to stick with him and make the tackle for the 2-yard loss. Back out to the 13-yard line, and on fourth and goal, Overton County will take the timeout. Fourth and goal for Overton County from the 13. We're in our first overtime. Everly will pitch back to Allen. He'll give on the reverse to Stevens. Stevens coming around the right side. Coming in now, Josh Walker back in. Stevens is the man that Garrett will replace. Gives to Allen. Allen tries the outside. And he is there. And he is the 14.
Chapter 9, Chris Everly. Chris is the son of Monty and Rachel Everly. And with Chris is Holly Franklin. Holly is the daughter of Nikki and Faye Franklin. Number 15, Josh Godsey. Josh is the son of Wayne and Candy Godsey. And with Josh is Amber Stewart, the daughter of James and Tamara Stewart. Number 26, Bill Garrett. Bill is the son of Butch and Vicky Garrett. And with Bill is Stephanie Thrasher. She is the daughter of Lisa and Jolie Thrasher. Number 38, Jonathan Stevens. Jonathan is the son of J.D. and Marla Stevens. And with Jonathan is Amy Harris. Amy is the daughter of Jerry Lee and Bobby Harris. Number 55, Derek Knappenberger. Derek is the son of Royce and Carla Knappenberger. And with Derek is Nicole Thrasher. Nicole is the daughter of David and Michelle Thrasher. Number 56, Andy Worley. Andy is the son of Gary and Winnie Worley. And with Andy is Lauren Linder. She is the daughter of Daryl and Missy Linder. Number 58, Matt Copeland. Matt is the son of Ruth Woolbright and Jeff Copeland. And with Matt is Casey Wendell. Casey is the daughter of Gerald and Vicki Wendell. Number 69, Nathan Clark. Nathan is the son of Norm and Annette Clark. And with Nathan is Mandy Maynard. Mandy is the daughter of Max and Donna Maynard. Number 70, Clint Melton. Clint is the son of Terry and Robbie Melton. And with Clint is Rachel Deck. Rachel is the daughter of Jim and Marcia Deck. Number 77, David Stockton. David is the son of Donald and Betsy Stockton. And with David is Beth Brady. Beth is the daughter of Herman Brady and Lisa Brady. Number 82, Christopher Hammer. Christopher is the son of Donald and Sheila Walker. And with Christopher is Tara Garrett, the daughter of James and Debbie Garrett. Number 90, Jeremy McDonald. Jeremy is the son of Robert and Brenda McDonald. And with Jeremy is Casey Parsons. Casey is the daughter of Number 42, Andy Gray. Andy is the daughter of Michelle Gray. And with Andy is Martina Hargis. Martina is the daughter of Rhonda Taylor and Keith Hargis. Ladies and gentlemen, your 1991 9-year-old Overton County Outlaws.
Thank you. Thank you.